going, guys? Welcome to another episode of the Vital Hockey 20. Today we got a special guest here. We got Todd Woodcroft. Todd's had an awesome coaching career so far at such a young age as well, with some stints in Sweden, some great work in the NHL with Winnipeg, which is his most recent job.
Yeah.
And yeah, so welcome to the show.
Well, thanks, Jimmy. I appreciate it. I'm actually a fan of your stuff. I've seen it and I enjoy watching it. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks a lot, Todd. So what are your thoughts? You presented today on Faceoffs. And I really like the presentation.
Thank you.
I've been coaching 25 years, and I learned like a handful of things.
Oh, thank you.
You know, and it's sometimes hard to go to a good conference where you can learn. But the guys here at the coaches' site really put on a good show, bringing guys like you in. So tell me, how important is it to win a draw?
Well, the first thing with a face-off is that's your first chance to have puck possession. So I remember a conversation with Mike Babcock. And him talking about the ability to have the puck even 5% more time in a game, that allows you to do a lot more things that you want to do. So I can't tell you how important it is to 30 other teams in the NHL now with Las Vegas, but I know that in Winnipeg we make faceoffs important from the beginning of the year. We make faceoffs a daily thing that we work on. It's a daily part of who we pre-scout and when we look at other teams, and it's a daily part for our centermen as an appreciable skill how they can get better every single day.
Well, it was amazing to watch some of the clips that you showed of your face-offs, just the awareness of your centerman to the positioning of the linesman.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about that.
Well, it's funny you say that because in Winnipeg, I guess we're fortunate that we have some young centermen. We have Brian Little, who's an elite face-off guy. And then we have three young guys, essentially, who take up a lot of our face-offs. We have Mark Scheifele, superstar.
Yep.
We have Adam Lowry, who's an emerging, excellent centerman. And Andrew Kopp is another guy who takes faceoffs for us. And even Nick Batan, another young player. So those guys are all under the age of 24 years old. And they're going against players who are have the opportunity to have taken 15,000 faceoffs in their career. The Mikko Koivus we play all the time, and we seem to struggle against them. Or, you know, you're going against Sedins and these guys who have 20,000 faceoffs more experience. Right. So for us, we need to find ways that we can bring the advantage back to us. So I guess specifically answer your question there, we need to worry about where the linesman's positioning is. We need to worry about the small details. And if we can influence the way that we can win a faceoff, any advantage that we can have to win a faceoff, we're trying to help our centermen find that advantage. So we're talking about where the referee's hands is, or where the referee's hands are, where the linesman's hands are in relation to the dot, because the dot, as a big circle, a referee's hand really can't cover the whole circle. So we ask our centermen to be looking at really controlling the area of the circle where a linesman or a referee's hands can be.
Yeah. Well, so with that being said, how many or how much time do you think you put in, say, in a four-practice week for, what, 1.5-hour slots?
Yep.
What percentage of that do you think is important for a minor hockey coach to spend?
I know you're lucky you get those 4 1.5-hour slots. In NHL, we don't have that opportunity to practice. So we have to be creative in how we do it. So we do our teaching a lot by video. We do our teaching a lot by emailing our centermen clips about the guys that we're going to play against themselves. We look at that a lot. But for minor coaches, which is a lion's share, I'm sure, of the people who are watching today, I think face-offs, it can't take over your whole practice, obviously, but it's a skill like any other skill. And if you don't visit it, somebody else is going to be doing it better than you.
True.
So I guess to specifically answer your question, I would say you need to find time for the skill of taking a face-off at the end of practice. Take your centerman and not just in the center dot where most teams find a disco in the center and we're going to drop 30 pucks each guy. Do it in different spots in the ice. Make sure they're switching so they're strong side and weak side and working on what they're good at, but also working on what they're not good at.
Right.
So if you can find time post-practice or even pre-practice with some of your centermen.
Well, it's funny because the first thing you said is that in Winnipeg, we are concerned about taking draws on all 9 dots.
Yeah.
I had to stop and count the dots in my head.
It's a funny one, isn't it?
But I love the one clip you showed in Sweden, in your time in Sweden, where it was a fun drill.
Yeah.
Actually, you turned the art of working on the seriousness of a draw into a fun game. Just talk quickly about that.
Well, I think the clip you're talking about, I think that was before, it might have been before the semifinal game. I can't remember, but I know it was an important game that we were preparing for. And we try to prepare for the centerman that we're going to play. So I will take one centerman and say, hey, I want you to be Claude Giroux today. And you're going to take a draw like Claude Giroux will take. And then in the clip you were looking at, it was Sedin. Sedin was working against a specific Claude Giroux thing.
Right.
But we try to make it fun by letting centermen turn their stick over if they're not a righty, but now they're a right stick, and just doing different ways to keep the energy up, to keep the fun part of things. But also the most important part is to compete. So for me, it's just been so fun being able to work with some of those guys, like a guy like Sedin or Backstrom, and guys that I watch and I try to learn from Faceoffs, of have just even a small voice around them, has been outstanding for myself.
Well, I think the key is, as a coach, you got a great guy here who has the ability to instill in superstars the idea that all five guys are responsible for winning a draw. Actually, six, a lot of times when it's in the defensive zone. So with that, I want to tip my hat to you.
Oh, thanks,
and
Shane.
As a young coach myself, looking up to guys like you, who've just found the niche and found the way to get your point across to some of the greatest players in the world. And
I think I'm younger than you, so let's just we'll call that one even. So thanks for having me on.
Thanks for coming out, Tom.
Okay, thank you very much.
Awesome, buddy.